Hey guys, what's up? It's Casey coming at you today. If you're new to my channel, I am a full-time eBay reseller. I go around looking for treasure to flip on eBay. So today I've got a challenge for myself. Also want to show y'all that it's not that hard to do, but we're going to try to make $100 in 1 hour between two thrift stores. I've got an hour. The travel time between each thrift store is about 10 minutes. So I'm probably going to spend 15, 20 minutes in each store. Maybe less. It depends on what I find. So hey guys, come along for the ride. Let's see what we can find. I will comp everything in the screen that I find. Also show you what time it is. Make sure you know that I am going to spend 1 hour to try to find this $100. So let's go. Let's go get it. 9:15. So we got the 10:15 to find my $100. So let's go. All right, guys. The first thing I did was go to the golf clubs. Of course, I did find a few things in here. It was worth some money. I'm going to show you and comp them out in the screen. As you can see, there is a Bazooka Tour Edge chipper. Chippers do sell pretty good, so I did pick that club up. Next club up was right beside it. It was a Callaway Solera. It's a ladies club. It's the A wedge to the set. So I went ahead and picked that up. Had some value to it. They were one of $5.99. And the next last club I picked up was a 3-iron hybrid by Adams. Pretty cool club. Should give me a little bit of money to go towards $100. I believe this section does have a lot of money. There's a lot of toys over here. I've been passing by a few months now. I have to dig through the bags and look. It would take a lot of time to research this, so maybe I'll do a video on it in the future. So I did not buy any toys in here, which I'm sure I did leave a lot of money on the table just for time essence here. I just stopped by the mug section, just kind of glance over just to see if there was any Starbucks mugs or anything that poked out. And fortunately, there wasn't anything that poked out, so I did not get any mugs from the section here. I came back over to the toy section to kind of give another glance over. If y'all guys have seen anything I've missed in the video so far, please leave a comment below and let me know. I would appreciate it. I did take a minute to look behind the counter here. Sometimes they'll put some cool stuff back there. They are priced up because they do know there is some value to it, but sometimes there is more value than what they're asking, so I do score some things, but unfortunately I didn't on this time.
All right guys, that thrift store was at, I mean, they were overpriced on a few things. I got a few golf clubs. I mean, if y'all don't know already, my niche is golf clubs, but I'm looking for other things to sell, so I don't think we reached the $100 mark in there. I spent 20 bucks. I'll throw sold comps in the screen for you. I'm headed to Goodwill now, so I got about probably 15, 20 minutes to shop in there before my hour's up. So hopefully we'll find something good to make the $100 challenge. So see y'all in there.
All right, we're at the Goodwill. See if we can finish out this challenge. I have about 15 minutes, so let's go in here and see what we can find. So as soon as I entered the store, I did notice a Magnavox DVD VHS combo. I usually don't pick these up, but this model in particular, I will pick up. They usually work, have no issues selling them. They sell very fast, so yes, definitely pick that one up. I actually left this DVD player behind, but after thinking about it, I came back over to look at it since it had the remote. I comped it out. It looked like it was going to be a good find to help me get to the $100, so I picked it up. So it was a good pickup there. I did search the store down for like 5 or 10 minutes. I looked through some golf clubs, some glassware. Unfortunately, I didn't find hardly anything. Shoes, I didn't find any shoes. Now, I did find this here underneath all these pillows. This was not put there. I did not put it there. It's not got a whole lot of value, but I did comp it out, and I wanted to get them $100, and I didn't know how far behind I was. That was a cool toy, so I went ahead and grabbed this. So it was pretty cool.
So 1 hour, I think I hit my $100
$100 challenge. Let's see what I got out of there. We got this Magnavox DVD player. Take my mask off. Can you hear me better? Got the Magnavox DVD player. Got it for $7.99. So I've comped this out. I comped it in the screen. It looked pretty good. Got some good sold comps to it. Let's get this one here. It's the Magnavox. I've sold this one before. I tested it in the store. I don't know if it'll play. Don't know if any of these work until we play them. I got that for $3.99. It's a Magnavox DVD VHS combo. It is the WMD 2205 model. I always pick that one up. This one sells very good for me. I just sold one. And then I found this guy in there. He actually sells pretty good. Got him for $1.99. You can see, $1.99. So it worked out. Played him in the store. Pops out. So hope we got some good stuff out of there to make up to the $100 bill. Hey guys, so I hope y'all enjoyed today's video. I spent 1 hour looking through two thrift stores trying to find $100 worth of inventory. So I think I did accomplish that. This will be included in my cost of goods. So, you know, whatever the comp is on eBay minus what I spent, kind of give an average off of fees of what I'm gonna profit. So this is gonna be for profit too, not all total value. So I will go in the next screen here and show y'all what that breaks down to be. So guys, hope you enjoy the video. If you also like looking for free stuff to flip on eBay, go to my last video. I did a quick video there. It was about 5 to 8 minutes, I think. It shows you what you pick up for free to flip. So I will do more videos on that in the future. Hey guys, subscribe, like. Appreciate y'all watching. Hit the comments and we'll see you on the next video. See ya. Okay, I wanted to show y'all that I actually went home that evening and listed all the items. I want to show y'all the breakdown cost of everything. So here's what I paid for the items, all six of them. And then on this cardboard, I did break it down to all the individual prices that I think I'm going to get in value for them. Looks like I'm going to make about $120 to $140 after listing all the items. I did get a sale that came through. Within 24 hours, I did sell the DVD player. I sold it for $69.99, free shipping. And I think the profit on that came out to be about $50. So, hey guys, again, thank y'all for watching. Please hit the like button and subscribe. And I'll see y'all on the next video. Thank you.